Hello friends, and welcome to all of you to the yet another session on assessment procedures. In our last session, we just talked about the income tax returns. Now we let's move forward and talk about the different topics under assessment procedures. Before we get into it, what is the assessment procedures? We first need to understand what is income tax authorities. So the assessment is done by the income tax officers, and in order to understand who actually does your assessment, we first need to see what is the income tax authorities, what are the different departments or different officers are involved in under income tax authorities. So let's start. In income tax authorities, the topmost official, or I say the topmost department, is CBDT, that is Central Board of Direct Taxes. So this is the highest authority in income tax. And under CBDT, we have two sub-departments which work parallels to each other, and these two departments are analysis wing and the investigation wings. Now let's see what are the different officers under these two departments. For this, let's start from the lowest department under income tax authorities. Under analysis wing, the lowest authority in income tax is the inspector of income tax. Above that, we have the tax recovery officer, and above to the tax recovery officer, we have income tax officer. Above income tax officer, we have the assistant and the deputy commissioner, and parallel to the assistant and deputy commissioner, we have deputy and the assistant director under investigation wing. Above to these authorities, we have the joint commissioner in analysis wing, and parallel to the joint commissioner, we have joint director in investigation wing. Above to joint commissioner and joint director, we have commissioner, principal commissioner, commissioner of appeals, and if required, we have the additional commissioner as well in analysis wing. Parallel to these officers, we have director and a principal director, and if required, the additional director under investigation wing. Above to these authorities, we have the chief commissioner and the principal chief commissioner in analysis wing, and we have the parallel to these officers, we have the director general and the principal director general under investigation wings. These two departments parallelly work with each others, and the analysis wing is actually done your assessment. You actually look into your returns, and in case any investigation is required, then the investigation wing comes into the picture. The important point here is to note that only these highlighted officers can assess your income tax return. Means the highlighted one can be your assessing officers. That is, in analysis wing, we have the joint commissioner, assistant and deputy commissioner, and income tax officers. And in investigation wing, we have the joint director, deputy, and the assistant director. Only these highlighted one can be your AO. So this is the most important point we need to understand and be aware of, that for any income tax return, only the highlighted ones can be your assessing officers. Now let's see the two important points with respect to income tax authorities. The first one is the CIT cannot be your assessing officer. CIT means the Commissioner of Income Tax. As I said, this officer cannot be your assessing officer. Only joint commissioner, assistant and the deputy commissioner, and the income tax officer in analysis wing can be your assessing officer, and parallelly in the investigation wing. So CIT cannot be your assessing officer. And the second point is, the CIT appeal is an independent income tax authorities. These are the part of income tax authority, but it is independent authority. Now let's move on and discuss about the power of CBDT. The Central Board of Direct Taxes has some powers. They can issue the notifications, they can issue the orders, as well as they can issue the circulars. So the notification issued by the CBDT prevails over the Act. For example, the date of extension of the return of income. Normally, the return filing deadline for an individual is 31st of July, as we discussed in our last sessions. But if any circular is passed by CBDT, or I say any notification passed by CBDT to extend that deadline, then that extended deadline prevail over the act and the orders. CBDT can also issue the orders. However, the two orders which CBDT cannot be issued. The first one is they cannot make a particular assessment. They cannot issue any orders to make a particular assessment. Side by side, they cannot issue any order in which they define the manner of assessment. It means any particular assessee's assessment order, they cannot issue the orders. Such order cannot be issued by CBDT. And in also, if any order in which the CBDT defines to do an assessment in a particular manner, that order cannot be issued by the CBDT. These two are at the discretion of AO. The limitation of CBDT is that power of CBDT is that they cannot interfere in the decision of CIT appeals. As I said, the CIT appeal is an independent income tax authorities. So any decision is passed by the CIT appeals. The CBDT does not have power to interfere in such decision. Now let's move forward and talk about the jurisdiction of AO. It is also a very good sections to discuss, that in under section 124, which talks about the jurisdiction of assessing officer. So how does the jurisdiction of the AO has been decided? If you are in person, and that person having the income under PGBP, then the place of business, or if that person having multiple offices under in different jurisdiction, then principal place of that business shall be the defining factor for the jurisdiction of AO. So the jurisdiction of AO is defined on the basis of the place of business or the principal place of business. However, if the taxpayer, or I say the person whose income is assessing and is a salary person, then the place of residence is a basis for defining the jurisdiction of the assessing officer. So in this way, we just quickly discuss the income tax authorities, what are the different powers of the CBDT, and how the different officers work parallelly to each other under different departments in CBDT. So in this way, we have discussed the hierarchy of the income tax authority. So one more point I just want to discuss under this section, that the jurisdiction of AO, if the assessee receive any notice, or I say any order or anything from the AO which the assessee wants to challenge for the jurisdiction of AO, then assessee can question the jurisdiction within 1 month from the date of notice. So whenever the assessee receive any notice from the AO and he feels and he wants to challenge the jurisdiction of that AO, then he needs to raise a question within 1 month from the date of notice. In this way, we have completed our first the part one of the assessment officer, which is income tax authorities. In case you have any question, please feel free to reach me to my email address, which is tarun298@gmail.com. In the next session, we just talk about the part 2, in which we will discuss the further sections in assessment procedures. So thank you and have a great day.